Today, we are discussing clothes and armor for the infected. Now, we've got a lot of info to cover and no time to waste, so let's get to it. Surviving in the infected is not one-dimensional. There are several things that you must keep in mind in order to survive in this game. Not only do you have the Vambi jerks and aggressive animals to deal with, you also have to contend with Mother Nature. During the summer, it can get extremely hot, causing you to overheat and die. During the winter, it can get frigidly cold, causing you to freeze to death. As such, this game has provided several clothing and armor options that allow you to combat these various difficulties. So today we're going to go through each of the armor and clothing options in the infected. I will demonstrate how to craft up each item and the benefits or negatives that each item will provide. But before we get into the individual pieces, let's start by looking at some of the resources and crafting stations that you're going to need in order to craft up all of the clothing and armor options. There are five primary resources that you are going to need in order to craft armor and clothing in this game. The first resource you're going to need is plant fibers. Now, of course, you can get plant fiber pretty much anywhere. Just chop down some trees and you will have lots of plant fiber available. The next item that you will need is feathers. And feathers you get from birds. Shoot the birds on the ground, or if you stumble across some dead ones, go ahead and harvest those up and get yourself some feathers. The next resource we're going to need is cloth. Cloth can be crafted at the loom, or you can loot cloth by looting the POIs in the villages. The next resource you need to be on the lookout for is Kevlar. Now, I would highly recommend trying to loot as much Kevlar as you can because it is extremely expensive to craft. It is crafted on the loom, but you will need 3 pieces of cloth, 3 plastic, and 10 plant fiber per piece of Kevlar. Now, cloth is not too terribly expensive to make, but plastic is extremely expensive to make. It requires oil, meaning that you will have to put an oil extractor down and get a whole bunch of oil before you can make plastic. So I would highly recommend trying to loot the Kevlar at the POIs instead of crafting it. If, however, you do find yourself short a couple pieces, you can go ahead and craft up some Kevlar at the loom. And the last resource that you need in order to craft all of the armor and clothing options in this game is copper. You need a copper ingot in order to complete your clothing set. Now, before we get to crafting, let's go ahead and take a look at our character. As you can see here, this is my character, and there are 6 different clothing slots available. You have a head slot, a chest slot, a shirt/jacket slot, a pants slot, a feet slot, and a leg armor slot. So there are more clothing and armor options available than there are slots that you can wear. And that's for a very specific reason that we're going to get into here in just a second. Now, in order to equip clothing, all you want to do is take it either from your clothing rack or from your inventory and just drag it onto the appropriate slot. So for instance, let's say I want to go ahead and equip my body armor here. All I do is just drag that to the chest armor slot. That plops it onto my character, and it is now equipped. And the same thing goes with all of the other items as well. So the boots go onto the feet slot, the helmet would go onto the head slot, your cargo pants would go onto the pants slot, your cooling shirt would go onto the shirt/jacket slot, the leg armor would go on the leg armor slot, and as we've already demonstrated, the body armor goes into the chest slot. So as you see, I'm fully clothed, but I still have some different options available. Now, in order to explain that, let's go ahead and get to crafting each of the armor and clothing options in the game. So in order to craft armor and clothing in the infected, you will need to get your hands on a workbench. Thankfully, all of the finished clothing and armor items in this game are standardized with regards to their crafting station. So all armor and clothing can be crafted at the exact same crafting station. Now, in order to find the crafting recipes, what you're gonna do is open up your inventory, click on the books icon right here, that'll bring up your crafting area. You're going to click on Itempedia and click on Armor and Clothes. That'll bring up all of the various clothing options in the game. And like every other crafting option, if you just hover your mouse over the item you want to craft, it'll not only tell you where to craft it, but it'll also tell you what you need in order to craft it. So for instance, the body armor here will cost us 5 cloth and 10 Kevlar, and it can be crafted on the workbench. So now let's go ahead and talk about each individual item. Now I'm going to break these up into different categories, and we'll take a look at crafting each of the items in these categories. And we're going to start off with your cooling items. As I mentioned, during the summertime, it can get swelteringly hot outside. You can actually overheat and your character will start taking damage. So during the summer months, you are going to want to wear your cooling gear. There are 3 main items that will reduce your body temperature, starting with the cap. Now, the great thing about the cap is it only costs you 8 plant fiber to craft. However, it does have a -5 heat factor, meaning it will cool you down. So you definitely want to be wearing a cap during the summertime if you start to overheat. The next cooling item on the list is the cooling shirt. This item will only cost you 4 cloth in order to make, but it will give you a -10 to heat. The cooling shirt is hands down the best cooling item in the game. And the last cooling item we want to talk about is the cargo pants. Cargo pants will cost you 6 cloth in order to craft, and they give you a -4 heat rating. So by wearing your cap, your cooling shirt, and your cargo pants, you can decrease your heat rating by -19 total. And there are some days during the summer months that are extremely hot, and you will need all 3 items in order to keep yourself cool. Now, one more thing to point out about these items is even though they're just basic standard clothing items, they do give you a little bit of armor rating as well. So for instance, our cargo pants give us a +2 to armor. So not only do they cool you down, they also give you a little extra protection against the vambies and aggressive animals. And the cooling shirt and cap both have a +1 armor rating. So just by having a cap, a shirt, and a pair of pants on, that will at least get your armor rating up to 4. It's not huge, but every little extra added bit of protection is a benefit. Every little bit counts. Next up, let's take a look at the winter gear. During the winter season, the winter months, it gets frigidly cold outside. So cold that you cannot be outside without your winter gear, otherwise you will freeze to death. First and probably the most important is the winter coat. In order to craft a winter coat, you're going to need 25 plant fiber and 10 feathers. Thankfully, the required resources for this bad boy are easy to come by. Plant fibers are everywhere. Feathers you get from birds that are either dead on the ground, or you can shoot them with your bow and arrow and harvest the feathers. The reason I say thankfully is because winter coats are so very important during the winter. That +10 to heat is going to be huge. It will save your life during the winter months. Next up, we have the snow pants. Again, another very, very important piece of winter gear. And like the winter coat, the crafting recipe for this clothing item is not too terribly expensive. Again, all you're gonna need is plant fiber and feathers. You need 20 plant fiber and 12 feathers. And similarly, it will give you +10 to heat. So the snow pants and winter coat are an absolute must for the winter season. You will absolutely have to have these on in order to get anything accomplished during the winter time. The great thing about the snow pants and the winter coat is they each also give you +2 to armor. So just by having your winter coat and your snow pants on, you will have a +4 armor rating. Again, it's not too crazy. It's not anything to write home about, but every little bit of armor counts. And the last group of clothing we want to take a look at is the armor. Now there are 4 main pieces of armor. Technically there's only 2, but 2 of these are best for armor, so I went ahead and added them to this group. So there are 4 pieces of clothing that we want to talk about. The first one on the list is the yellow helmet. And the reason I added it to the armor section is because it does have a pretty high armor rating. Relative to the other piece of headgear that you can wear, which is the cap only has a +1 armor rating. Plus it has a -5 heat, so I felt it was best to leave it in the cooling section. The yellow helmet has a +4 4 armor rating. It also gives you +2 to heat, so you can wear it during the winter time, no problem. You can pretty much wear it whenever and not have to be too concerned, except for when it gets really, really hot out, then you might want to swap out the yellow helmet for the cap. In order to craft the yellow helmet, you are going to need 3 cloth, 6 Kevlar, and 1 copper ingot. Not only does the yellow helmet increase your armor rating and give you a little bit of protection from the cold, it also has the little yellow light right on the top of the helmet. So it actually adds a light to your character as well. So I've actually gone ahead and equipped my helmet, and all you have to do is press L, and that will turn on your helmet light. So that's with the light on, that's with the light off. That light is absolutely awesome. Especially if you're going into caves or after dark, that light can make it so you can actually continue working after the sun goes down without having to stumble around like a fool. It gets very dark after the sun goes down, and having that light on your helmet is awesome. So again, not only does that helmet give you +4 to armor and +2 to heat, but it also comes with that handy dandy light that you can turn on when needed. The next piece of armor we want to take a look at is the body armor. Now this will cost you 5 cloth and 10 Kevlar in order to craft. It is extremely expensive when it comes to Kevlar, but it is also highly worth it. That extra +14 to armor is huge. It also gives you +4 to heat, meaning that it will raise your body temperature. So you do have to be careful with wearing your armor during the summer months, especially when it gets really, really hot outside. Next up in the armor section is the leg armor. This will give you a +10 to your armor rating and a +2 to your heat rating. In order to craft the leg armor, you are going to need 5 cloth and 8 Kevlar. Again, it can be a little bit expensive. 8 Kevlar is kind of a lot, but again, it is also worth it. That +10 to armor rating is huge. And the last piece of armor is the boots. These will give you a +6 to your armor rating and a +2 to heat. In order to craft the boots, you are going to need 4 cloth and 4 Kevlar. But just by wearing these 4 pieces of armor, so the boots, the leg armor, the helmet, and the body armor, that will give you an armor rating of 34. Add on top of that the extra armor that you get by wearing regular clothing, and you can bump that armor rating up to 38. The higher your armor rating, the less damage that you will take from the vambies and from the aggressive animals. So when you get to the point where you can start crafting armor, I would highly recommend that you do. It just may save your life. Now I'm gonna quickly demonstrate crafting of the clothing and armor. I'm not gonna craft every single individual piece, but I am gonna demonstrate crafting in general. If you ever have any questions on how to craft an item in this game, definitely hit up the Itempedia. It'll not only tell you what resources you need in order to craft a specific item, it'll also tell you which crafting stations that you can craft that item on. So we're just going to craft some basic cloth items here. I've got a full stack of 10 cloth, and I'm going to go ahead and go through a few of the options available. So as you see here, I have 3 cloth on my workbench, and that will allow me to craft up the t-shirt. All you want to do is just move the resources onto the workbench, and that will allow you to craft the specific items. So 3 cloth will get us the t-shirt, 4 cloth will get us our cooling shirt, and 6 cloth will get us our cargo pants. Then all you have to do is just hit the craft button, and that item will be added to your inventory. Clothing and armor in this game does not degrade. Once you have it forever. So don't worry about crafting multiple items, unless you are trying to have different sets at different bases. So if you have multiple bases across the map, in that instance, it might be worth it having different clothing sets at each of the various bases. Otherwise, stick with one. One is all you really need. Now, quickly, I want to demonstrate what happens if you wear the wrong clothing in the wrong season. So right now, I have my helmet, my chest armor, my winter coat, my snow pants, my leg armor, and my boots. Each of these will give you a plus to your heat rating. So right now, my heat rating is 30. However, it is June. It's the middle of summer. You do not want to be wearing your winter gear during the summer months because you will quickly overheat. And if you look in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, you will see that warning sign. It says, warning, overheating. That is telling me that my body temperature is way too hot. And if we take a look at my character stats, I am losing health. There went another hit point. You will slowly lose health if you are overheating during the summer months or if you are freezing to to death in the winter months. So it is very important to keep an eye on your body temperature. If you see that overheating or that freezing symbol in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, swap out clothing in order to regulate your body temperature. So since this is the summer months, I'm going to be taking off my winter clothes and putting back on my cooling gear, and vice versa during the winter months. So during the winter months, you want to take off your cooling gear and put on your winter gear. If you do not, you will die. Slowly but surely, my hit points are continuing to tick down. So once you see that warning symbol on the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, take it seriously and get your clothing options sorted as soon as you can. Otherwise, you will continue to lose hit points and you actually can die. The Infected offers several obstacles that the player must overcome. Not only do you have to fend off the vambi jerks and aggressive animals, you also have to deal with Mother Nature. Getting too hot during the summertime or too cool during the wintertime will lead to your demise. Thankfully, this game also offers a wide variety of armor and clothing options that you can use to combat these difficulties. Now, if you'd like to see some more tutorial videos on The Infected, I've created a very special playlist that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.